In the earlier videos of this series, we learned types, group values, and we talked about the benefit of coding and dealing with types rather than values. We mentioned functions are simply mapping between types. We also learned about higher order functions and how we can pass functions around as values. In this video, we will learn about another abstraction above types and type constructors, and we will see how all the previous concepts we learned also somehow exist in our new abstraction as well. So let's start this video by looking at values again. We are already familiar with values like 12, hello, and true. When coding in JavaScript, we are operating within the value universe, where we use these values to perform various computations to create libraries and applications. We also already know that we can group these values into sets called types, such as integer, string, or even function types like integer to boolean, as well as more complex types like option of boolean. This is the universe in which TypeScript operates in. We move to a higher level of abstraction where instead of dealing directly with values, we focus on types. This gives us type safety and helps us stay away from unwanted mistakes by delegating some of the responsibility of testing our code to compilers. So now if you try to assign a string hello to an integer variable, the compiler alerts you, saying you are probably doing a human mistake here. But our journey of abstraction doesn't end here. There is a third universe that abstracts similar patterns in the type universe. To explain this, take a look at option type constructor. What is an option by itself? We know option of boolean is a type and we can easily list the values inside it. But option by itself seems to be incomplete. We need to pass a concrete type to option to receive a concrete type, like passing boolean to option, which gives us option of boolean. Let's consider this as the type for the type constructors like option in our third universe. Type to type groups and represents all the type constructors that need only one concrete type to create a new concrete type. It's like they are acting like functions, but for types. And this is how we abstract over the type universe. We call this third universe the kind universe. Let's take a look at another example. What is a kind of integer type? Integer is already a concrete type, so the kind of integer is simply quote-unquote type. What about either? If you remember, either type constructor receives any two types like E and A and returns a union of left and right of those types. So either receives a type and returns another type constructor that receives another type to finally gives us a concrete type. Doesn't this remind you of carried functions? And the list goes on. So we created another level of abstraction over types and type constructors. Just as values can be grouped into types, types and type constructors can be grouped into kinds. In fact, types can be seen as type constructors with zero number of type parameters. We also saw that type constructors look like carried functions. In order to see why we are adding another abstraction over types, let's take array as an example. And by array, I mean array in type-safe languages like TypeScript. Array keeps a sequence of items with the same type. It doesn't care what type it holds. All the operations array cares about, like appending or prepending, is not depending on the type it wraps. In other words, array is abstracting over the type it holds. This is nothing new. Array is a structure with a generic type variable. But if we can abstract over the type our structures hold, can we abstract over the structures themselves? Meaning, can we have a piece of code that doesn't care about the structure and behaves the same regardless of what type constructor it uses? Can we have a generic type constructor like F that represents the common behavior between type constructors? The answer is yes, and this is called higher kind of type. Doesn't the name remind you of higher order functions? Let's look at kind of array. Array receives any concrete type A and returns a concrete type array of A. So array kind is type to type. What about kind of f of integer? It first needs to receive the type variable f. What is a kind of f? It's the kind of array, list, or option, which is of kind type to type. And by providing our structure f, we get a concrete type. As an exercise, try to think how you can implement this behavior in TypeScript. This is called lifting a value to a context in functional programming. We will see how to do this in future. Pay attention to these parentheses. These are important to differentiate between our higher kind of type here with the kind of something like either. Either receives two concrete types to give us a concrete type, while the other one first receives a structure of kind type to type to give us a concrete type. In other words, our operation of partially applying concrete types is right-associative. Right-associativity means that when we have a sequence of a same operation, the priority of grouping and applying those operations are from right to left. If you want to show this precedence with parentheses on the either kind, it would look like this. Now I think it's more obvious why we needed parentheses for the kind of f of integer. We've already seen another use case in which concept of kind and higher kind of types would help us. In the functor video, we learned functors are structures that are mappable, like option, list, and either. What all these structures have in common is that they have a map function. But this map function is defined differently for each of them. Although the type of these map functions are different, they look pretty similar. These are only different in the type constructors they are using. It would be nice if we could abstract these type constructors and simply pass it to our type definitions, same as A and B. The other difference here is the kind of either is a bit different than optional list. Either needs two concrete types instead of one. We can fix that by partially applying a concrete type to either and convert its kind to type to type. And now it seems we find a solid pattern between these map functions. So if you want to model all these map functions under a single definition named functor, it would definitely be a higher kind of type. This means functor would accept a generic higher order type variable like f. The tool that lets us define such a definition in functional languages is called type class. Obviously, these syntaxes are made up and they're not TypeScript. We will look into type classes soon. But for now, thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.